What's up YouTube, French Tech here. So 5 tips that will allow your battery to stay healthy for years and years to come, and I promise you, no BS, this actually works. If you watch this video until the end, you will never ever have to replace your battery again or replace your laptop if you are using a MacBook. So anyway, tips number one, and I really want you to hold on here. It's theory time, guys, but I promise you, it's just 15 seconds. After that, all the tips will make perfect sense to you, okay? So what is a battery? All the modern batteries out there are actually lithium batteries. They are actually composed of a cathode and an anode. When the battery is fully charged, all the particles, like chemical particles, are on the cathode, which is like the positive pole. And when it is empty, all the particles are in the anode, or like the negative pole. And we never want all the particles to be stuck on only one pole. Like, this is too much stress for this pole, the positive or the negative one. And I know if there is like physicist or like scientist or something, or 15 years school guys watching this video, you will be like totally shocked. But for the others, I think this makes perfect sense to you, right? So tips number one, never let your battery drops to 0%. This can really destroy your battery in the long run. Always try to charge it at 20%. And I know sometimes it's not possible, and that's totally fine, but you need to avoid it becoming a habit. One thing that you can do is that when your battery is below 50%, you can enable power saving mode so that you will have enough time to go back home or to find a charger or whatever, but you'll have time to charge it back. Also, if you have this smartphone or laptop or this device that you never use, well, don't forget to charge it every now and then so that the battery will not be ruined. Tips number two, never let your battery at 100% for too long. Actually, a lot of people don't know that, but it is actually as deadly as leaving your battery at 0%. What you need to avoid is using your phone or laptop when it is still plugged. One thing that I used to do, but I stopped doing it because it was killing my phone, was using it as a 4G hotspot. Like, I was plugging my phone and using it for Wi-Fi connection, and I was doing that for hours and hours, and this was killing my batteries. Like, 1 week or 2 weeks, I had my battery level drop to 80 or 85%. That was like, it was like a big deal, and I never knew what the problem was, but actually it's the problem. I was leaving my battery at 100% too long and too much. For laptops as well, if you are using them as a stationary PC, like they are on your desk and they're plugged all the time and you are always using them like that, it's not a good thing actually to do. You need to unplug them from time to time and let them drop to 20% and then charge them back. It's okay to leave them like that for a few days, but every 2 or 3 days, just unplug them, let them like draw battery into 20% and then charge them back. What brings us to tip number three, which is a smart charging mode. This feature is available on all smartphones out there, Android and iOS, and if it's not enabled on your device, you need to do it right now. What this feature do? Well, remember tip number two, we don't want our phone to stay fully charged for too long. But what happens when like you leave your phone at night before just going to bed, leave it to charge? There is like this big chance that your phone will charge in 1 or 2 hours and then will stay fully charged all night long. And when you wake up, like you have your phone at 100%, but it was staying at 100% for 5 or 6 hours. Well, smart charging mode is using AI to calculate when you usually wake up. So if you wake up usually at 7 a.m., the phone will start charging until 80% and then stops. But later at 6 a.m., he will charge the missing 20%, so that when you wake up, the phone was just finished charging and it was not staying at 100% for too long. And I know that this feature is also available for some laptops out there, so you may as well go ahead and check if your device supported or not. Tips number four, subscribe to my channel, because I'm a lifesaver. Avoid high temperature. Number one enemy of batteries is high temperature, you know, because of the chemical and stuff, you know. Like, I don't know the theory behind it, but what is well known is that you need to avoid high temperature because it will kill your battery, and it's only a matter of hours. Like, your battery can be ruined in 1 or 2 hours. So be really careful about that. For laptops, for example, don't use them on a couch or on a bed because the materials can heat up really quickly. Do not leave them to charge inside the closed box, for example, or don't drop them over your bed and let them charge just right there. One more thing that you can do, and you can save some degrees with it, don't let your laptop in direct contact with your desk if you are using it as a stationary PC, for example. One accessory that I use and that I really recommend is this laptop stand. link in the description. This allows a better air circulation between the laptop and your desk, and it's also good for your neck. What? All of that for 10 bucks? Really? One last thing, if you are noticing that your phone or laptop is heating up too much, well, it may be a good thing to stop what you are doing with it right now and let it cool down for a bit, because sometimes the fans just can't keep up. Okay, tips number 5, lifespan. Like I said in the theory part, like charging is this particles moving from positive pole to the negative pole and or from the negative pole to the positive pole, and like every time when there is like this energy transfer, there is some particles that are lost in the middle of a process. Like this is physics, okay? So in the long run, if you charge hundreds and hundreds of time, you have lost so much particles so that there is no more chemicals in your battery, like there is only 70 or 80% left. And by the way, this is like the number when you check the battery health status page, the 70 or 80% percentage that you see there, it's like the number of chemicals, of particles inside your battery. So what I mean by that is that batteries have limited lifespan, mostly listed in the constructor website. For example, for Apple, I found this one. You can see for a MacBook Air, the limit is 1000 charging cycles before it drops dead. A charging cycle is what it takes to drop from 100% to 0% and then charge it back. It is actually a full charging cycle. So if I check for my MacBook Air, for example, it takes around 3 days to consume a complete charging cycle. I'm using the M1 Mac, and these devices tend to not consume too much energy. So in my case, if I use my battery properly to use the 1000 charging cycles, it will take around 3000 days, and that's almost 8 years. So this can be actually a really good thing to check if you are planning to buy a refurbished or a used laptop. So that's it for my tips. I hope it was helpful. If so, please consider subscribing to my channel and drop tons of comments. I really enjoy reading them. See you in the next video. Bye bye.